So today I am going to explain experiment number 2 in the engineering mechanics lab, that is bell crank lever. Okay. What is bell crank lever? Actually, bell crank lever is used in the ancient time to ring the bell in the church. Okay. So you can consider this bell crank lever with the help of some wire, if they will pull it, the bell will actually ring. Okay. So that is the actual the apparatus used for. Now this apparatus we can use to verify the principle of moments. Okay. So the objective of this experiment is to verify the principle of moment using the bell crank lever apparatus. Okay. So this is the bell crank lever. Okay. This apparatus. Now what we need to complete this experiment? We need bell crank lever apparatus, we need hanger, and we need weights, scale for measurement, and speed lever to check the lever on the lever. Okay. Now this is the free body diagram of this particular calculation. In this free body diagram, this is basically the tension in the spring. Okay. This tension in the spring is applied on the vertical arm of the bell crank lever, and all the weights we have to hang on the lower arm of the or the horizontal arm of the bell crank lever. Okay. Now these are some identification of the what are the notation we are using or symbols. Y is basically the distance from the fulcrum to the T or the tension in the spring in meters. This distance. Okay. Now X is the basically the distance from the fulcrum to the weight in meters. This. Okay. From here, from this point to the position where the weights are hanging in the lower or horizontal arm of the bell crank lever. Okay. We can use three different type of weights. Weight 1, weight 2, weight 3 at different distance. Okay. Now T is basically the tension in the spring in newtons. We can use in kilogram also. Okay. We can use kilogram also, no problem. And this W is the weight which is hanging on the horizontal arm of the lever. Okay. Now what we have to do? We have to do some observations. This is the observation table. In this observation table, we have to take the reading for all the particular identities in the bell crank lever. Okay. So after that, we have to calculate the final tension in the spring balance. Okay. And this is the calculation, the momentum about the bell crank. Okay. So this is the formula of the calculation. How you can calculate T into Y minus W1 into X1 minus W2 into X2 minus W3 into X3. Okay, these are the weights. Okay. These are negative because it is applied in the opposite direction. Okay. Now this is the result we can get it out. Now I will explain a little bit about the apparatus. In this apparatus, this is the adjusting screw. We can adjust the level of this. We have to make this horizontal arm horizontal while taking the reading. Okay. So we can change this length and we can rotate it and we can change the position of this particular arm. Okay. When we lose it, the arm will be go down. Okay. So this is the spring balance. Okay. This is the spring balance for taking the reading in the tension which is due to these weights. Now there is a split lever, we have to use it. This split lever we have to use it to measure it the horizontal position of the lever. Okay. When we have to make it horizontal, the bubble has to become in the center. Okay. So this adjustment we have to make with the help of weights. Okay. We have to put the weights in the hanger, then the split lever will come in the center. Okay. And this is vertical arm and this is horizontal arm. Okay. And this is the weights or the hangers on which we are putting the weights on the machine. Okay, so this is the small description of the experiment. So now we can take first reading in the apparatus. So the level of this we have to adjust by this screw, adjusting screw. So for taking that, first we have to take the initial reading of the spring balance. Okay, from here you can take the initial reading from the spring balance. So presently the spring balance reading is 1 point initial reading. Now we have to put the weight at a specific distance from here. Okay, so the scale is already given here. Okay, how much is that? This is around 30 centimeters. So it is 0.3 meters. It is 0.3 meters.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, at this particular point, we have to put the weight.
10.1.
Yeah. So now, we take the initial reading of the spring balance. Now, we have to put this 5 Newton of weight in the hanger. Okay. Now, we already put 5, so we have to take it the 5 Newton. All are Newtons. So this is 5 Newton. Okay. Now, what we have to do? We have to change this spring balance reading. We have to make it horizontal with the help of this spring balance. Okay. Presently, it is not in exactly the particular center point. We have to make it at the center. So for that, we have to adjust the screw. We have to change this length, then make it. You have to loose it a little bit. Then the bubble will come in the center.
The spring will change. Yeah.
Yeah.
It may change.
So the spring, so the split level bubble is coming in the center. So this particular arm is in the horizontal. Now we have to take the reading of the spring balance, how much it is coming here. Okay.
16.
It is 16.2. Okay. So what will be the final tension in that? So we have to
Minus 16.2.
16.2 minus 10.1. So the final will be, it is 6.1. Okay. So this is the final reading of the tensor. Okay. We got the weight. So one more important reading is remaining, that is wire. Okay. Wire we have to measure from the fulcrum. Okay. Now we have to measure how much it is. So it is totally the 30 centimeter. Okay, from here you can, this is the fulcrum and this is the axle distance, axle which is going, the tensile axle, it is going from here, so we can consider it is 30. Okay, so 30 centimeter means it is 0.3 meters. Okay, so we got the distance for the weight, we got the distance for the spring balance, and we got the tension. And W2, W3, X2 and X3, we can use some more hangers to calculate it. Okay? So for the calculation, we can consider only this part. Okay? Presently, we haven't put the weight 2 and weight 3. So what we will have to do? We have to calculate our, how much it is? 10. And how much is the weight? W1, it is 5, that is minus 5 into how much it is? Sorry, this tensor we have to take it. Sorry for that. We have to take 6.1 and how much it is? 5 weight into 0.3. So approximately it will come how much? 6 into 3 into 16? 18.3 minus 5 into 10, it is
1.5.
1.5, sorry, this will be
1.8.
1.8. Okay, so it will become 0.3. So it is approximately to 0. So we can say that the sum of the momentum of all the forces will be close to 0. So these are the error, and these error are basically comes due to the friction in the Vankram and this weight of the spring balance that we have to consider. So due to that, the errors and maybe some errors in the spring balance. So this error is approximately, you can consider it as a 0.